Welcome to Yung Tuition. Today is 23rd September 2023. Let's continue discussing basic issues in physics with simple description for the general public. Although the anthropogenic climate change has been taken for granted by many, the natural climate system of the Earth has been amazingly stable over the past century. Look at the random variations about its mean value of the air temperature over the past century in the continental United States. One can hardly notice the change about 1 Kelvin. Why? Today, I'm going to draw your attention to a number of facts and factors that may well have been overlooked by climate researchers. Before we go, please like, make comments, and subscribe, as well as keep the bell activated. Are you ready? Let's go and have fun. The Earth has been a unique member in the solar system for at least 4 billion years. It is reasonable to assume that its climate system must have been regulated by some powerful and intelligent mechanism with several standing points. Otherwise, the Earth wouldn't be capable of maintaining its biosphere long before humans appear. It is essential to understand that such a natural climate stability is dynamic, with a certain range of variations, rather than a static without any range of tolerance. So, whenever you find any anomaly or some difference from the certain mean value, you can call it climate change. But if that change is relatively small and within the range of tolerance, then you can still conclude the climate system is stable and normal. This way of thinking is much more important when the uncertainty in measuring such an anomaly is comparable to or even larger than the measured anomalies. So far, it would appear nobody could measure a reliable global mean surface temperature because the surface area is huge, which implies, in my opinion, it is still too early to conclude the 1K increase in the surface temperature is reliable. Now, let's have some close look at how a long-term mean air temperature is measured step by step, starting from a diurnal variation in your backyard temperature, if you wish. Once you display the measured instantaneous air temperature, you can see time-dependent random noises or stochastic fluctuations. Why? Because the atmosphere is constantly adjusting its temperature distribution towards a thermal equilibrium, determined by the periodical solar radiation and the response of the atmosphere and the surface as a whole. Unfortunately, many people seem to have forgotten such endless efforts constantly made by the Earth toward the thermal equilibrium, because what they could easily see are complicated weather changes or the weather noises, as termed by Klaus Hasselmann, which appear random and purposeless activities. Further, as I discussed in my previous talk, Hasselmann argued that the climate stability is merely determined by the accumulation or mathematical integral of such weather noises. This idea is nonsense. How could the Earth just act as a drunk who can do random walks similar to the Brownian motion? To obtain the trends of the diurnal variations in both the air and the surface temperatures, you can filter out such random fluctuations to obtain smooth curves as shown in this diagram. Notice the air temperature is always different from the surface temperature, except for two time points, about 8 a.m. and 8 p.m. But the air temperature is usually measured 2 meters above the ground. If you try to measure the air temperature very close to the surface, the air temperature would be fairly identical to the surface temperature, as shown in this observation. By the way, the fact that the air temperature would be identical to the ocean surface temperature was mentioned by Frankenon and Hasselmann in their paper published in 1977, as you can read. In fact, it is known that the heat exchange across a sea surface rapidly leads to an adjustment of the surface air temperature to a value fairly close to the local SST, namely the sea surface temperature. Next, let's expand the time scale from a few days to several years. The air temperature variation looks like a sine wave now. That's why I use this sine function to approximate it, which can be extended to many years in the future if the mean value keeps as constant. Assuming this observation was done in the northern hemisphere, it is simple to use this blue sine curve to represent what would be observed in the southern hemisphere at the same latitude, of course, which should be pi opposite in phase, or it should be upside down, in other words. Obviously, care must be taken when you hear the report that the hottest July has been recorded in this region, because you have to consider the observation in another hemisphere if it is hotter too. In general, such annual variation pairs are canceled out once they are added up. So far, your observed periodical variations can be attributed to the spin of the Earth and its orbital motion around the Sun. More complicated variations were first calculated by the happiest prisoner, Milankovitch, which provides some remarkable explanation for the onset and the repetition of the ice ages, during which the global mean surface temperature could be over 10 Kelvin lower from that in the interglacial period. This could be described that the Earth have more than one standing point, or attractors, as implied in the Lorentz differential equations. That's why the Earth has successfully adapted to a number of ice ages so far. Unfortunately, such a powerful and natural thermostat regulation capability of the Earth has barely been discussed by many climate researchers. Perhaps that is because they might have thought the climate system should be described either as a static without any anomaly in the measured surface temperature, or merely driven by CO2 and other trace infrared absorbers to display increasing anomalies as long as the CO2 concentration is over 300 ppm. In summary, the basic issue in understanding the climate system of the Earth is to investigate its natural capability to regulate its thermodynamical variables so that to adapt different influences, including volcano and solar radiation, rather than to justify the incorrect greenhouse effect hypothesis by computer simulations. Thank you for viewing. Thank you for donation. See you next time.